It is another time of learning and networking at the 2017 Social Media Week in Lagos.
We do blogging full time.
It is one of the biggest gathering of youth and industry experts in Nigeria.
You really get me because
people from all over the nation and Africa converge in the city of Lagos once in a year to network, discuss, strategize, and provide ideas, trends, insights, and inspiration to help people and businesses understand how to achieve more in a hyper-connected world.
And to the discerning consumer.
Started in 2012, the Social Media Week is a global phenomenon and a leading news platform allowing people to share the best ideas and insights into how social media and technology are changing businesses, society, and culture around the world.
Appreciate quality, then you're going to fail.
This is its fifth edition, with a five-day event playing host to 323 speakers, cutting across over 50 sessions.
You said something about DVDs and...
Industry experts from various sectors of the economy are present to explore this year's theme, the new language of technology, the future of communication in Africa. The rise of social media journalism, a competition on complementary, is the topic of discourse at this session. The speakers, who are seasoned journalists from both the traditional media and social media, had their thoughts on the issue. Social media journalism, the speaker says, is the new face of journalism in Nigeria.
If the social media is a threat, the answer is yes. Something takes away 80% of your content, 70% of your revenue, it's a threat. But that it's a threat does not mean it will get the traditional media into extinction.
My own view is that it's neither complementary or competitive. It's just the future of journalism. It's technology taking you to a new level of operation.
And at this session, using technology and social media to counter violence against women and girls is the topic of deliberation.
There are facilities from...
The speaker said, though social media has helped to counter violence against women and girls, by letting more people know about the resources available, social media-fueled gender shaming continues to lead to and worsen the attitudes that legitimizes gender-based violence.
And I think one of the key things, while we keep on seeing these forms of gender-based violence, and I want us to also keep in mind that it's rather than violence against women, there are also the traditional harmful practices, female genital mutilation, early child marriages, and things that happen just because a person is a woman. And a key factor responsible is the lack of strong legal frameworks that deter people from committing this act, that punish offenders of this act, and the absence of remedies or reparations. I don't know what I'm going to use best. Sort of for the victims of this, so it allows the impunity to continue without being checked.
Movies. So first, if you're.
And this is the Nollywood session.
Officers that have been trained.
The Nigerian movie industry, popularly known as Nollywood, is the world's second largest movie producing industry by volume, worth over $5 billion.
They're out there, they're ready to, you know.
According to the speakers, challenges in the forms of piracy and the lack of enough distribution channels are the largest plagues eating up the profits and hindering the growth of the industry. The experts say, though social media has not fueled piracy in Nigeria, the platform, if properly harnessed, can be used to stop this criminal act.
I think piracy has always been there. Social media didn't fall it, but social media didn't lead to piracy. Piracy is something that you have to fight differently. Piracy can be fought on social media by people who do things that are being pirated. People who speak for these people can say, listen, don't patronize this, don't pay attention to this, and don't buy this because it's not original. So social media can actually be used to combat piracy to a large extent.
Other sessions were discussions cutting across politics, banking, agriculture, music, business, law, and a few master classes highlighted the event. The initiator of the Social Media Week has a lot to say about this year's event.
You know, I think it's been another incredible week, a week of innovation and just seeing the positive attitude of the next generation of Nigerians, what they're doing with technology, how they're using technology, how they're innovating in their businesses and their personal lives, how they're using social media to drive their various agendas. And I think when you see all of these things and the convergence of culture, content and technology, which is really what Social Media Week is about, and the opportunity it's giving Africans, the black diaspora, to embrace and to use, to have access to tell their stories. And the most important thing that's coming out of Social Media Week Lagos this year is the importance of owning your own narrative, either as an individual, as a brand, as a country, as a continent, and as a race.
Social Media Week hosts conferences on six continents, including Europe, North America, South America, Africa, Australia, and Asia. With over 70,000 physical attendees, 5,000 speakers, and more than 1 million people connecting through social and mobile, Social Media Week is set to be the world's most important source of information in regards to the future of human connectivity. Flourish Alunge, TV 360, Lagos.